sweltering with the heat of oppression, be transformed into an awakening. Roll still is not free. 100 years later, the life of the Negro is still sadly crippled by the manacles of segregation and the chains of discrimination. 100 years later, the Negro lives on a lonely island of poverty.
When you're in pain, pray this song when you're feeling sorrow. The devil will test your faith in your hour. Prepare for despair, brighter days will follow. Endure the rain somewhere. Shine tomorrow, stay prayed up. And send a messenger down, stay prayed up. Prayer so profound, stay prayed up. Yeah, stay prayed up. Pray this song when you're feeling sorrow. Any hour when the devil is testing your faith in your hour. Pussy break men mentally. She's one that wasn't meant to be. Stop simping, G. She's your worst enemy. Social media stripping, she is shaking her ass on TikTok and IG. Just wicked women want to be the next modern harlot. They used to go viral. Another broken family, kids without a father. Our wickedness is little to women we all know. But trying her spirit just might be a hoe. If my breath starts flowing today, I'm on my way. Yahuwah sent for me, leaving expeditiously. Some will read my books, try to mimic me. Death's a guarantee. Eve's in debt with a PhD. Gave up on me, I came a long way. Said I would fall, I made it anyway. This song's for those about to give up on their dreams. Turn nightmares into wonderful things. Hate is dead, nouns, I'm speaking life. You must decide what your story's about. Critics wrote me off, I saw no end in sight. Now I'm showing the haters how to win in life. Like I cast it in the ground, they put me down. I'm reincarnated, critics look at me now. Pray this song when you're feeling sorrow. The devil will test your faith in your hour. Prepare for despair, brighter days will follow. Endure the rain somewhere. Shine tomorrow, stay prayed up. It's in a messenger down, stay prayed up. Prayer so profound, stay prayed up. Yeah, stay prayed up. Reminisce about early times, I wore hand-me-downs. We had no iron, me and my brother in the kitchen, in the cold house bitching. I thank dad and mom, enduring racism, making the decision for having us children. Dad is dead and gone, now your son is building up a legacy. My father said to me, son, create a dream to focus on. Mother said, fast holes will trick you, son. Said, I'm not Jet Li, I'm not the one. Don't want a thought brains game, I'm in the plain jeans. Traditional women whole state in your lane, got a hot mileage pussy, too many things like an accident. The girl's getting banging, send her tricity. She's on ecstasy, need a lobotomy. Gave too much brain, said you don't need a man, you would die alone. Heart filled with pain, repent and shoot your whore or your ass is damn. Pray this song when you're feeling sorrow. The devil will test your faith in your hour. Appear for despair, brighter days will follow. Endure the rain somewhere. Shine tomorrow, stay prayed up. It's in a messenger down, stay prayed up. Prayer so profound, stay prayed up. Yeah, stay prayed up.
I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up, live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal. I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia,
Right, Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom. So we're going to go into today, we're going to talk about spiritual harlotry, how people, according to the Bible, that's into astrology. All you Moors, all you Eves out there, because you love astrology, psychics, nemancers, dealing with medium spirits, tarot card readings, palm reading. According to the Bible, all of that is occultism. And according to the Bible, all of that is of the devil. And so I saw before we even started the video, we had thumbs down. It was down to 80 some percent. And the only reason that the video will be like that, because your spirit got cut just from the topic. And so you know you're going to get cut. So you're trying to give a thumbs down, but you're not going to stop this truth. This truth is going to spread throughout the world. And so the Most High, from my opinion, my perspective, and I'm entitled to that, the Most High used Danielle Johnson, the astrologer, tarot card reader, as an example of what he's going to do to those operating in the spirit of Satan, making evil fair seeming. And so this is what they do. I don't know if you guys have paid attention, but if you look at Fox News, they allow a lot of astrologers and psychics on there. That's of the devil, man. They're using the devil to get views, man. So we have to talk about it. We have to bring it out, man. We have to bring it out. Now, since it is the Shabbat, I would say happy Chavez to those of you that keep Chavez for the Shabbat. And so we're going to start with a short reading. If one of the good brothers could read something from the Torah, then we're going to go directly into this message and deal with Danielle. What was that woman that came on here, Kadar? What was her name? I can't remember her name, man. She talked on me with the phone. See, that's Satan trying to lure you in for hours.
Kahan.
I didn't even remember her. Hey, that's when the Most High is giving them up to that reprobate mind. But let's read something from the Torah, and then we'll go right into this message.
Kahan, we're going to be reading from the book of Leviticus, the 23rd chapter. And Yahuwah spake unto Moshe, saying, speak unto the children of Israel, and say unto them, concerning the feast of Adonai, which ye shall proclaim to be holy convocations, even these are my feast. 6 days shall work be done, but the seventh day is the Sabbath of rest, a holy convocation. Ye shall do no work therein. It is the Sabbath of Yahuwah in all your dwellings. These are the feasts.
Salakia, I want to say this. We're live on Rumble also, and we're live on X, formerly known as Twitter. So any of those accounts, if you don't like to be on YouTube, I'm live on X and live on Rumble also. Just put in Tazadaq or Kahan Tazadaq. I got it up. Figure out how this thing appears up on X because I don't see it.
These are the feasts of Yahuwah, even holy convocations, which ye shall proclaim in their seasons. In the 14th day of the first month at even is Yahuwah's Passover. And on the 15th day of the same month is the feast of unleavened bread unto Yahuwah. 7 days ye must eat unleavened bread. In the first day ye shall have a holy convocation. Ye shall do no servile work therein. But ye shall offer an offering made by fire unto Yahuwah 7 days. and the 7 day is a holy
Everybody go to everybody that's on this call, just go to X real quick and give it a thumbs up. I see it now. You know what? I'll drop the link in the room. You got four people viewing. So I, because from henceforth, when I go live on YouTube, I'm going to be going live on X, aka Twitter. I got it. I'll select it.
Book of Leviticus 23:8. But ye shall offer an offering made by fire unto Yahuwah 7 days. And the 7 day is a holy convocation. Ye shall do no servile work therein. And Yahuwah spake unto Moshe, saying, speak unto the children of Israel, and say unto them, when ye be come into the land which I give unto you, ye shall reap the harvest thereof. Then ye shall bring a sheaf of the first fruits of your harvest unto the priest. And he shall wave the sheaf before Yahuwah to be accepted for you. On the morrow after the Sabbath, the priest shall wave it. And ye shall offer that day when ye wave the sheaf and he lamb without blemish of the first year for a burnt offering to Yahuwah. And the meat offering thereof shall be 2/10 deals of fine flour mingled with oil, an offering made by fire unto Yahuwah for a sweet savor. And the drink offering thereof shall be of wine, the fourth part of an hin. And ye shall eat neither bread, nor parched corn, nor green ears, until the self same day that ye have brought an offering unto your Lord. It shall be a statue forever throughout your generations and all your dwellings. All right, that's our short reading from the Torah.
The water. Todah. So we're gonna deal and get people to see people starting to come on the call. Again, we're live on X. When you come in, give a thumbs up. We're live on Rumble and we're live on YouTube. We're going to put this message all out there. So we're going to deal with Danielle Johnson. Danielle Johnson is Elohim's warning. It's the danger of being involved in spiritual harlotry. I'm going to warn everyone that may be listening. This stream right here, it contains a recollection of crime. And it can be triggering to some of the listeners. So discretion is advised. Now, if you are someone that you know or considering suicide, please, please get help. Don't go out like Stefan. Don't go out like Marty. Please get help. Contact the National Suicide Hotline. Call 1-800-273-TALK. That's 8255. Now, since I got that out of the way, if you look in the average newspaper, magazine today. Now stop me where I'm lying at, Yimmy Yahoo. You see some sort of horoscope or something about the zodiacs. Stop me where I'm lying at. The average newspaper magazine, you look in it, you see something about some sort of horoscope.
That's facts. That's facts.
The world has diluted astrology so much that many of you believers, so-called believers, right? Many of you so-called Christians, say so-called because you're really not true followers of HaMashiach. Many of you Jewish people, many of you Israelites, right? You forget that it actually has its root. Astrology has its root in occult practices of fortune telling. And so that's what I want to talk today, because people already gave this video a thumbs down, and it shows you don't know what the heck you're following. And unless you repent and come out of that, you're condemned. You're condemned. And that's what happened with Danielle Johnson. An unclean spirit got on her. They pretend they don't know what's going on. Things are so mysterious. No, an unclean spirit got on her, just like any of you Eves that's under that vibration. I'm going to say to all of you Moors, all you Eves, anyone that's under that vibration of astrology, it's occultism. And I've heard people like Satnet and them trying to justify occult. Man, you invoking other spirits when you're dealing with that. Some people look to the stars to get advice. But what does the scripture say? What does I deny say about that? You better think twice before relying on these practices, astrology, palm reading, tarot card reading, psychics. That's all divination, man. So what happens? The eclipse. Venture to a place known as Los Angeles, California. A Los Angeles woman was reported to have killed her boyfriend. I mean, it was something, man. I hate to say it, but this guy, you know, he's the kind of men that I, Kadar, Yimmy Yahoo, and Benaya, that's on the call right now, try to warn you guys not to be. This is why we warn you so hard, man. That's the type of man you don't want to be. He slept on her, man. He couldn't read the demonic spirit in her. And so what happens? She killed her boyfriend by repeatedly stabbing him. She tossed both of her daughters, a baby and a nine-year-old daughter, from a car. Then the demonic entity that attached itself to her, because she's the host. She wasn't herself anymore. It attached itself to her. And she was reportedly driving over 100 miles an hour and slammed into a tree. And the demon took her life. She didn't take her own life. The demon took it. Just like Stefan, a demon got on him, man. A demon got on Stefan, man, and caused him to take his own life. See, while driving Danielle Johnson under the vibration of the demon, dealing with astrology and tarot cards, threw her daughters out of the car. And then she died in what they refer to as a suicide, crashing her car into a tree. See, that's what demons do, man. They attach over to the host, and then they control you. And all you that's under this vibration and this astrology, and you think, yeah, these people are giving you knowledge, man, the same thing could happen to you if you don't come out. Now, the distressing sequences happen around 4:30 on Monday, April the 8th, 2024. Y'all remember that eclipse of the sun? People looking up to the sky. I say, listen, man, you guys better know what you're doing, man. Everybody excited. You had Cynthia talking about. Yeah, the eclipse. Well, you see what that brought in? You see what that brought in? Just like the Passover is going to bring it. A lot of you guys, shortly after the Passover, is not going to be around anymore. Now, you can remember I said that. And you're going to wish you had listened and got your spirits right. So the police, they reach the 405 freeway in Culver City, California, and they found the body of the infant. An infant, Yimmy Yahoo, lying next to the nine-year-old sister on the roadside. Can you imagine that? What kind of mother throws her children from the car? Huh?
That's crazy.
Car.
That's crazy.
Listen, man.
And it's unfortunate that the infant didn't survive. I'm talking about an infant, man. How you take a little infant? What kind of demon? That's got to be demonic, man. There's nothing else. There's nothing else that can ascribe to that. Huh? And people that's into this astrology, and if you don't come out, good riddance. Good riddance. Because what comes to you, you're going to deserve it. The infant didn't survive, but the 9-year-old girl was rushed to the hospital. And I hear that she's undergoing recovery. Cops travel. They tracing. They say, how could this have happened? Well, so they travel 15 miles and they discover 15 miles away, the police find the body of Johnson. Danielle Johnson. After she crashed a car into a tree. See, people, a lot of you people don't believe demons exist in this world, man. Because they can't see it. See, they so damn carnal, Kadar. If they can't see it, they don't think it exists. They say, oh, you believe in a mystery God. Okay, keep going. Her boyfriend, Jalen Chaney, he was found dead. Guess how he was found dead? A neighbor saw blood seeping from the door. See, this is what happens when you're a docile man. This is what happened when a feminist system is set up. And Eve could get away with anything, any kind of lie. The neighbors said they heard arguing going on. What? And it's always the man's fault. You see what I'm saying? They thinking, ah, he's over there arguing with that poor girl. That's the natural paradigm in the society, man. But the neighbor saw blood. See, she stabbed him, Yemiyahu. He fell face forward in his own pool of blood and was lying there. The door was left open. He was a boyfriend. This woman, she's influenced so many people on social media, over 100,000 followers. Nevertheless, Jalen Allen Chaney was discovered by a neighbor in their apartment when the neighbor noticed blood seeping under the door. On Tuesday, the next day, the Los Angeles Police Department gave additional information. So according to the investigators, Chaney and Johnson were heard arguing around 3:40 a.m. on Monday. And then the altercation obviously escalated to a fatal outcome. She was 34 years old. She stabbed him to death. Stabbed him to death. But it's the woman that's always the victim, they say, huh? She stabbed him to death. The LAPD, they finally disclosed that the bloody knife that was used by Johnson that had this demon attached to her, it was recovered at their residence. After the incident, she's said to have fled the apartment with her two children. She done stabbed this man. Now, imagine this. Put yourself in this place. She done stabbed this man to death. She grabs her two children, and she jumps in the Porsche. Because remember, she living all right. Who's Lee Israel, man? Who's Lee Israel that's trying to get in the room, and how did they get a link? I don't know who that is, y'all. Lee Israel, who are you? I don't know who that is. I don't know how they get a link either.
I don't know who it is.
So they won't be coming. Lee Israel, put who you are in the comments. I have no clue who you are, but I know I didn't send you the link. The guy's brother. Name was Matthew. He said that his brother had embraced this woman's daughter, his older daughter, like it was his own. He said he never even knew his brother to really like children, but he adored this woman's daughter. He absolutely adored her. But they say the reason behind Jalen's death is a mystery. It's not. See, it's only a mystery to those not rooted in the word, man. It's no mystery. A demon just jumped on her. That's what demons do, man. A demon will hop on someone that calls them to do something wicked and then leave, and they don't even know what the hell happened. Half of the time, they don't remember what happened. Because then that demon leave and go and get on someone else. If you guys haven't seen that movie, The Fallen, with Denzel Washington, that's one of the best depiction of how demons work in movies that I ever seen. Thanks. How that demon was going from host to host. One of the neighbors eventually stated that the couple was residing in an upscale apartment for just over a year with the two children. And the neighbor said, one of them said that we heard the couple arguing in the middle of the night. And then they discovered a trail of blood leading from the apartment. So that means this woman left with blood on her. Oh, a trail of blood leading from the apartment the following morning. And he said the door was wide open. There was blood on the floor leading into the apartment. And then a trail of blood leading to the elevator and some blood on the walls. So that demon done jumped all over her after she done stabbed that man. She doesn't even care what she's doing. You know why? Because the demon had already told her, you got to take yourself out. Now, I know a lot of you don't believe this stuff is real, but you're going to find out that it is. And if you don't get out of it, it's likely to happen to you. So the woman's father contact 911. And they say when they told him, when they spoke to the EMT, to go and check on the body. So the neighbor did. And so the neighbor said, when I entered the apartment, the neighbor found that Chaney, the guy, her boyfriend, was dead, face down, in a pool of blood. Left him in his own pool of blood. Shout out to Jeremiah for the tights, the donation. We got 5,000 some people on here. Let's get some donations in the room. 5,275, except for Yahushabi. So they say in a troubling text message from November 2022, this guy, Chaney, had told his brother that, yo, man, I've been dealing with a lot of personal things with my girlfriend, and I don't really care to share what it is right now. It's not appropriate. See, he probably talked to her about what she was doing, huh? He probably noticed an alteration in her personality. This dude was in the Air Force. But he had dreams of being a weatherman. They say they don't know the motive of why she killed this guy, her boyfriend. The daughter that survived was turned over to CPS. Do you understand what she done to her daughter? Now, see, we here at the True Disciples of HaMashiach, we've warned women again and again. Have we not? Women that come on here talking about astrology, talking about zodiacs, talking about tarot card readings, talking about psychics, and so on and so forth, palm readings. We warn them again and again. This is all occultism of the devil. And it allows demons to attach to the host. So let us first, because some people gave the video a thumbs down. So let us first begin by determining whether or not astrology is occultism, or is it just entertainment? See, this is what most of these people don't know that get involved in this stuff. Astrology has its root from fortune telling, which the Bible considers an occult. The Bible considers that useless, a useless practice. See, astrology is based upon the use of stars and the planets to read into a person's past, present, and future. Remember some of them come on here, Kadar, say, oh yeah, we're in the age of whatever they say. I don't even listen to it. Yeah, we're in the age of such, oh, the moon is in this position.
Straight foolishness.
See, for many astrologers, it's a belief that, just like, I can't remember that, because the Most High don't want me to remember her name. That Eve that came, man, you think I want you? We'll be two warring spirits, man. See, for many astrologers, it's a belief that the position of certain celestial entities have an impact on their lives. That's what she was saying. That lady that came on this channel a few weeks ago.
Come.
Come. Yeah. These unclean spirits attached to these people, man. Now, for other astrologers, there's a belief that there are gods in celestial bodies that impact our lives. See, the Bible warns against this, man. The Bible warns against worship of other gods. There's some Christians, there's some Jewish people, there's some Israelites, Muslims that support the ideas that the stars and planets are actually representations of other gods. And the trend is growing. As you see, this woman had over 100,000 followers on X. But the Bible states that occult practices are wrong. It is sinful. And that we should not seek fortune tellers, mediums, and any kind of practitioners in occultic practices. And astrology is an occult practice. See, a lot of these predictions we see don't come to pass. See, the main concern is that when believers look to astrology for advice over Adonai, that's the main concern. If Christians, Jews, Israelite, Muslims, whatever you're calling yourself, look to astrology first, then they're taking their eyes and trust away from Yahuwah. Many believers only glance at the horoscopes to laugh at the generalized prediction. Remember, say, oh, you was born, oh yeah, yeah, we're compatible. We're not, man, don't, you can miss me with that foolishness, man. Let's go to the book of Shemot, Exodus 20, verse 3. Let's establish this first, man. The Most High don't want you worshiping anyone by him. Exodus 20 and 3.
The book of Shemot, Exodus, chapter 20 and verse 3. Thou shalt have no other gods before me.
See that? The Most High said, you should have no other powers before him. From there, let's go to 2 Kings 21, verse 6. Because Manasseh, or if you're incompetent, one of those followers of Hulan Mitchell, you might say Manasseh. I don't know how in the hell you get Manasseh out of Manasseh. That's some hood prison garbage, man. You understand what I'm saying? How do you get Manasseh from Manasseh? Well, we're going to see that Manasseh sacrificed his own sons to the fire. That's occultism, man. So it's not uncommon for our people to be in this nonsense, man.
Look at 2 Kings chapter 21, verse 6. And he made his sons pass through the fire and observe times and used enchantments and dealt with familiar spirits and wizards.
See that? Familiar spirits and wizards. Read on.
He wrought much wickedness in the sight of Adonai to provoke him to anger.
Yeah, so he did most wickedness in the sight of the Most High, arousing his anger. From there, let's go to Devarim 4:19. See, we was warned not to do this nonsense, huh? They still trying to justify it. Now you see how these demons attached to this host, man?
Khan, it's the book of Devarim, Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 19. And lest thou lift up thine eyes unto heaven, and when thou seest the sun and the moon and the stars, even all the host of heaven, shouldest be driven to worship them and serve them, which Yahuwah, thy supreme Allah, thy supreme power, hath divided unto all nations under the whole heaven.
So the Most High is controlling those things, huh? The Most High is controlling that stuff, man. How did the sun get there? How did the moon get there? It was Adonai that done that, man. Now, I got a question. Do stars give advice? Do stars offer advice, Nefertiti? Of course, if you get hit on the head, you might start calling yourself Manasseh and think that means Manasseh. See, the Bible states that stars, along with the sun and the moon, were created to give light to the earth, not for you to worship, man. Yahuwah is one, and Yahuwah is the only one who gives believers right advice. Stars could be quite useful, as in case of the wise needing to find their way. The wise men use it to locate HaMashiach, the baby, and providing the location. But in this case, Yahuwah used the star to light the way, not to worship, to light the way. It was only used as a light. Let me hit you with something, man. To all of you that think otherwise, the Bible is very critical against astrologers. In astrology, asserting that they can actually, they can't save the people of the Most High, man. See, in Yeshaya, some of you might call it Isaiah, the Bible points to this issue when the Most High proclaims that doom will come to Babylon. And there's nothing the astrologers can do to save these people from it. But in the earth, today's era, they generalize horoscopes. They said the horoscopes could determine who you could be with. Let's go to Bereshit, Genesis, first chapter, and read verse 16 and 17. They worshiped the sun, they worshiped the moon, they worshiped the planets. The Most High created all of this stuff, Nefertiti.
Book of Genesis, Bereshit, chapter 1, verse 16. And the Lord made two great lights, the greater light to rule the day and the lesser light to rule the night. He made the stars also. And the Lord set them in the firmament of Shemaiah.
That's good. That's good. And the earth. Come on. From there, let's go to Yeshaya 47 and 13. All your counsel is supposed to come from the Most High, man. So when you say the planet being here causes this, and this causes this, all your counsel is supposed to come from the Most High, man. Every other counsel that you see is going to wear you out and put demons on you. Isaiah 47 and 13.
Look at Isaiah chapter 47, verse 13. Thou art wearied in the multitude of thy counsels. Let now the astrologers and the stargazers, the monthly prognosticators, stand up.
That means people that predict, prognosticators, those that get involved into predictions, like psychics. Okay.
And save thee from these things that shall come upon thee.
So the prognosticators are people who predict things month by month, like the so-called horoscopes. Most I said, let them come and save you, man. They can't save you, man. He said they're like stubble. Read on.
Behold, they shall be as stubble. The fire shall burn them. They shall not deliver themselves from the power of the flame. There shall not be a coal to warm it, nor fire to sit before it.
See that? They can't save you, man. They didn't save her. Well, who is she called on? Satan? Now imagine this seconds before her death. Put yourself in up. You driving towards a tree, man, at full speed, over 100 miles an hour. What the hell you think is attached to you, man? What's in your mind? See, that's how Satan attaches to his host, man. So I would like to continue this morning with the definition of the term occult. Occult. So that everyone could get a clear understanding. And an occult is anything designated or belonging to an occult. It involves dealing with the world of spirits. Spirits. Or supra. Someone look up the word occult. Supernormal forces. And these forces are not oriented on Hamashiach, Yahusha, that you call Jesus Christ. You're dealing with the devil. Someone look at the word occult.
Khan, it says secret, not divulged, hidden, concealed, secret, cover over, concealed.
Now, what did the Most High say about someone that does something in secrecy like Masons, like Shriners, like Elks, like the Illuminati?
It's a sin, right?
No, I'm asking a question, huh? You're supposed to provide the answer.
Why would a man hide his light in a bushel? I might be paraphrasing that wrong, but...
No. That's one of them. Someone give me Matthew 18, verse 7. He said, woe, destruction. Woe does mean destruction to them that do things in secrecy. Matthew 18 and 7. Midi Yahu.
The book of Matthew, chapter 18, verse 7. Woe unto the world because of offenses, for it must needs be that offenses come. But woe to that man by whom the offense cometh.
the causing offenses. Give me that one that you had, Benaya. What man have of light and put it under a bushel basket? Huh?
Come on, that's Matthew 5.
Yep.
Yeah, someone give me Yeshaya 29 and 15.
This is the book of Matthew chapter 5, verse 14. Ye are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hid. Mm-hmm. Neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel.
Yeah, now righteous men, man. Why are you gonna light a candle and hide it? You're lighting the candle for the light so that everyone can see the light. You know what I mean? Go ahead. Isaiah 29 and 15.
Man, finish that verse up.
Yeah, go ahead. Finish that one out.
But on a candlestick and giveth, and it giveth light unto all that are in the house.
See what I'm saying? So why Masons, why the Illuminati, why is these fraternities doing things in secrecy? Because they're against the Most High. That's Antichrist. Isaiah 29 and 15. Isaiah 29 and 15.
The book of Isaiah chapter 29 and verse 15. Woe unto them that seek deep to hide their counsel from Yahuwah, and their works are in the dark. And they say, who seeth us and who knoweth us?
See that? So the Most High said destruction unto these people that do things in secrecy, man. And a cult is secrecy. So with this definition, it suffice to say that the reality of a spirit world and of the mysterious, meaning secret, right? Supernormal forces. They call them supernatural, right? See, you churches, you synagogues, you temples, you make grave mistakes when you say that the supernatural phenomenon are restricted to another age or only to godly people who could work miracles. That's a lie. Satan, did not the scripture say that they would have power, and if it was possible, they would deceive the very elect, that he will work wonders? He will work wonders in Matthew, the 24th chapter. So these people do have powers, man. But their power is coming from Satan. Someone give me that in Matthew 24, man. They will call wonders, man. They're gonna have powers, man. Satan gives them power. That's why they're selling their souls, anyways. So the churches, the synagogues, and all these people make a mistake when they say only godly people have these powers. That's a lie. Go read what you got, huh?
Book of Matthew, Book of Matthew, chapter 24, verse 24. For there shall arise false Hamashiachs and false prophets.
The word Hamashiach, he's talking about your means Christ. There shall arise false Christ, guy.
And false prophets, and shall show great signs and wonders.
So these people have powers. We see that they will. They will show great signs and wonders. So we're going to stop right there. They can show great signs and wonders. That means they say, damn, how do you do that? God must be working with you. How could he do that? Satan will make one of his followers rich to make you want to emulate that lifestyle. See, Satan, he's not going to get you with something you don't like. He gets you with something that you like. So you wonder why Eve could go on OnlyFans and make millions of dollars because she's a whore. And that's what Satan condones, but the Most High condemns. See, ain't no fornicators in the kingdom of man. Ain't no whoredom in the kingdom. So if she could fix that, she's going to die, man, and burn forever. And we're talking about people's spirits now. Finish that out, Jeremiah.
In so much that if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect.
Con. So if it was possible, they would deceive the very elect. And so this goes to the most blatant Satan worshipers, to the most commonly accepted uses of horoscope. It's all in the same category. Astrology is worship of the devil, man. What's that? When they call that thing, it begins with an N.
Necromancer?
Yeah, necromancer. Necromancer. Yeah, necromancy. So all of that is dealing with the devil, man. Necromancy, ESP. Yeah, some people, hey, I got ESP, I can read your mind. That's of the devil, man. That's of the devil. But what do you call it? Seance, necromancy, communicating with the dead, PSI, ESP, all forms of supernatural psychic phenomena, real magic. You're like David Blaine, huh? Yeah, all right. All that's of the devil, man. Hand tricks. You like it, but it's of the devil. Fortune teller cards. Casting of spells. Wearing charms. Eve said, oh, put this crystal on. Put this crystal. That's of the devil, man. Using Ouija boards. Astrology. The Moors love astrology. Because it's of the devil. So what I intend to continue to show in this live is that the Most High forbids this stuff, man. So either you're on the side of the Most High and I'm a Shia, or you're the devil. And so Danielle Johnson was used as a warning to all of you that's under these vibrations, man. Leviticus 19:31. Shout out to Jai Deer for the donation. Leviticus 19:31.
Come.
The book of Leviticus.
The book of Leviticus.
Why don't we just continue to go in order, man? That way we won't have this. We can just continue to keep it in a cipher, man. Go ahead, huh?
The book of Leviticus, chapter 19, verse 31. Regard not them that have familiar spirits, neither seek after wizards to be defiled by them.
Yeah, necromancers, wizards, God.
I am Yahuwah, your power.
Come. From there, go to Leviticus 20, verse 6. Necromancers, wizards, soothsayers, all of that nonsense. Astrologers. God.
Book of Leviticus, chapter 20, verse 6. And the soul that turneth after such as have familiar spirits and after wizards to go whoring after them,
So now you understand why I say Danielle Johnson was a spiritual harlot. Because her soul went after this stuff. And the scriptures are saying right here in Leviticus 20:6, if you turn after these mediums and you go horn after them, then you're a spiritual harlot. And what would the Most High do? Read what you got. God.
I will even set my face against that soul and will cut him off from among his people.
Is this not what happened to Danielle Johnson? Is this not what happened? Can anything happen if the Most High didn't allow that thing to happen? Nothing can happen. It's the Most High allowed that thing to happen, man. Deuteronomy 32:39. It couldn't happen, man. From there, let's go to 1 John 4, verse 1. Can't believe every spirit. She got 100,000 followers on X, Twitter, right? The Most High say, don't believe other. And they tell, oh, yeah, she been helping people. They under that vibration, huh? And see, that's the thing, huh? When you get, when Satan get a hold of you, it's like a bad wife, right? The Bible, you'll read 20 verses in the Bible where it tells her to obey her husband. This woman is still go read the Bible, get on her knees, and pray to Satan and swear she's praying to the Most High. Because we know the Most High's not hearing her prayers, huh? Because she's going against his laws. And that's what happened when Satan attaches one of his demons to you. You can't hear right anymore, man. You have a reprobate mind. All right, go ahead, read what you got, huh? Thumbs up. Thumbs up.
Look at 1 Yochanan, chapter 4, verse 1. Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits, whether they are of Yahuwah. Because many false prophets are gone out into the world.
From there, let's go to Leviticus 20 and 27. See, they didn't try his spirit up. There's no way you're going to have 100,000 followers. So what, you got 100,000 demons up? These people have sold their soul. And I'm going to tell you, everybody that was following Danielle Johnson on Twitter, on X, you need to go and repent. Go and repent. Because the Most High is not playing with neither one of you, man. And when these demons start chasing you, you can't get away. You can't run. Why do you think she was driving so fast? A damn demon was after her, huh? Where are you gonna go? You can't go nowhere. See, they don't think it's real until it's on them. That damn demon, we whispering, damn demon whispering in her ear, huh? She stabbed a man multiple times, man. Left him in the pool of blood with the door open. And then the demon whispered in her ear to take her children out. Then take herself out.
This is the book of Leviticus.
Imagine that. There's four souls Satan trying to take out at once. For whatever reason, the Most High spared the nine-year-old. This is too heavy for someone you might want to sign off. This is not for the weak at heart. Go ahead, huh?
This is the book of Leviticus, chapter 20, verse 27. A man also, or a woman that has familiar spirit, or that is a wizard, shall surely be put to death.
See that?
They shall stone them with stones, their blood shall be upon them. So that's, and
that's it right there. We just want that. That's the judgment that the Most High had for these, according to the law, man. That's a judgment according to the law. From there, go to Deuteronomy 18:10-12. Because you people was burning. Our forefathers used to sacrifice their children, man. Where you think they got it from now, man? You're trying to put that on Esau. What did the Most High say in Yemiyahu 2:31? You've taught the wicked man wickedness. That's in Jeremiah 2:31. Deuteronomy 18 and 10.
The book of Deuteronomy, Deuteronomy chapter 18, verse 10. There shall not be found among you anyone that maketh his son or his daughter to pass through the fire, or that useth divination, or an observer of times, or an enchanter, or a witch, or a charmer, or a consulter with familiar spirits, or a wizard, or a necromancer. For all that do these things are an abomination unto Yahuwah.
And because of these abominations, Yahuwah thy Allah doth drive them out from before thee.
It's a filthy, wicked act, man. It's an abominable thing. Go to Galatians 5 and 19. That the New Testament don't change it up. The word of the Most High stays the same. These false prophets coming, you guys in sheep's clothing. Oh, yeah, astrology. Oh, brother, which month were you born? Oh, yeah. Hallelujah. You see the stars. The sun is in this, whatever they be saying, huh? Yeah, the moon is in this something stage. We're in the stage of Saturn. Man, get the hell away from me with that, man. Come on. I'm throw some holy oil on you, man. I'm going to pray and throw some of this oil on you and see if you burn. Come on. These precepts start coming out. They can't stay around. The demon can't stay in the midst of the word of Yahuwah, man. They want to get away, man.
Come on. The book of Galatians, chapter 5, verse 19. Now the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulations, wrath, strife, seditions, heresies, envyings, murders, drunkenness, revelings, and such like, of orgy. The which I tell you before.
Yeah, one of those words over there meant orgies.
Come. As I have also told you in time past, that they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of Yahuwah.
So David, and all these people got to repent, man. And a lot of you damn jakes, you like to be involved in orgies, huh? You jakes, you like threesomes with these wicked Eves, man. But if you don't get over that, you're not going to make it, man. You're not going to inherit the glorious kingdom, man. That's wicked, man. That's fornication. Ain't no fornicator is going to make it into the kingdom, man. So you better repent now, man. You better fast and pray. Revelations 21 and 8.
The book of Revelations, chapter 21 and verse 8. But the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable and murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone.
That's where they're going. Go ahead.
Which is the second death.
That's where they're going. That's how the Most High is going to deal with them. So, do me a favor. All you Eves out there, it's teaching people about astrology, all you Moors, please stop putting diviners on your channel. I'm begging you. Because what you're doing is you're adding the devil. The devil is using you people, man. The devil is using you people, are using you people to put divination in the minds of people who are simply trying to learn the truth and find themselves. See, this is what the devil does. This is his agenda. How do you do it just for ratings, man? For money. But you're not going to take that with you when you go. You think she took her? You think Danielle Johnson took her ratings with her? You're going to have to draw a line in the sand and decide what you're going to do. Please the Most High or continue to try and please man. Astrology, tarot cards, these things can be used to call dark spiritual forces as a way to reach people that otherwise they wouldn't be made aware of this divination. Scriptures condemn this occult. We read scriptures after scriptures. The Most High clearly bans occult from the life of his people.
I was going to say, in fact, she lost the only thing that she could take with her was her soul. Gone.
Moses addresses the people just before they cross the Jordan. Just before they cross the Jordan River and entered into the promised land and drive out the pagan nations. What did he say to them? Someone give me Deuteronomy 7. He said, you should not learn these abominable practices, man, of these nations. They should not be found among you. Anyone in Deuteronomy 18, we read it, 9 through 12. He said, that should be not found among you, anyone. A bunch of sons or daughters in the fire as an offering. Anyone who practices divination, a soothsayer, an enchanter who looks for omens, a sorcerer, a charmer, a medium, or a wizard, or a necromancer. He told us to stay away from all that stuff, man. And he said, whoever does these things is an abomination to the Most High, that power. And so because of this abomination, the Most High said to drive him out from amongst you, or you stone him to death, according to the Bible. So Moses mentions, well, go back to Deuteronomy 18, verse 9 through 12. When you read that, Moses mentions eight spiritualist activities. He mentions divination. He mentions soothsayers. He mentions augury. He mentions sorcery. He mentions the use of charms. He mentions mediums. He mentions wizards or necromancy. And these are not clearly distinct activities. They overlap each other sometimes. Sometimes they're used interchangeably. But what they all have in common is they all involve efforts to obtain knowledge, which is usually hidden. And that's what makes it an occult. And the meaning of attaining it is usually through dealing with the spirit world, with mysterious supernatural powers. But the dread say, yeah, man, I smoked the herb. Put me in connect with the spiritual world. You damn right it does. But with other spirits.
Oh. This is the book of Deuteronomy.
Well, we don't have to read it. Let's not read it since we read it already. Because there's something else. I don't want to stay on this too long. There's something else that these eight activities have in common. Is the knowledge sought is not out of idle curiosity, but is out of some desire to exert some power over people. They want to have power over other people or events. And that's the clearest. That's the clearest definition of someone that's a charmer. In verse 11, someone read verse 11, Deuteronomy 18, 11. See what that's talking about? That's talking about one who binds a spell. Read that, Ephraim. 18,
11. Deuteronomy 18, verse 11. Or a charmer, or a consulter with familiar spirits, or a wizard, or
this is the use of psychic or spiritual forces to control another person or to control a course of events. See, that's the goal. That's their goal. Now, what's an example of that? When King Moab sent Balaam money for divination, someone get Numbers 22 and 7. This is what it says. Numbers 22 and 7.
Book of Numbers, chapter 22, verse 7. And the elders of Moab and the elders of Midian departed with the rewards of divination in their hand. And they came unto Balaam and spake unto him the words of Balak.
So his aim was not to conquer the land, to find out whether or not Israel was going to conquer the land. His reason for contacting Balaam was to pronounce a curse on Israel by his magic arts. But what did Balaam say? Read verse 23. Okay.
Book of Numbers, chapter 22, verse 23. And the ass saw the angel of Yahuwah standing in the way, and his sword drawn in his hand. Numbers 23, 23. Book of Numbers, chapter 23, verse 23.
Okay.
Surely there is no enchantment against Jacob.
Read that again.
Surely there is no enchantment against Jacob.
In other words, the Most High say, if the Israelites are true believer, you can't work no magic against him, man. Balaam told him himself, you can't work no magic against Jacob, man. If he's a true believer, if he's walking in the spirit. There's no enchantment against Jacob.
Come.
Yeah, go ahead, huh?
Neither is there any divination against Israel.
See that? You see, if you're walking in the spirit, they can't do nothing to you, man.
Right.
So these eight occult activities mentioned in Devarim, Deuteronomy 18, 10 through 11, they're literally meant basically to illustrate all these activities which these people deal with, the world of spirits, or these spiritual forces in order to get secret knowledge and have power over people or over particular circumstances. So now, what does Moses say about these activities? Let's read that. Deuteronomy 18, verse 9. What does Moses say about it? He calls them abominations. And that means the Most High hates these things, man. He regards them as detestable, abhorrent, loathsome.
It's the book of Deuteronomy, Deuteronomy, chapter 18, verse 9. When thou art come into the land which Yahuwah, thy supreme Allah, giveth thee, thou shalt not learn to do after the abominations of those nations.
So what Moses called abominations. Now you can stop right there, verse 9. See, the Most High hate them things. Moses called it an abominable thing. That's something that the Most High hates, man. Most I hate them things. It's an abomination in the eyes of the Most High, that power. Let's read verse 12. See, according to verse 12, the person who does these things are an abomination to the Most High. Not just the things themselves, but the person that does it, the Most High hates you. You're an abomination to Adonai, that power. He don't only hate the activity. We learn in verse 12, he hates the person also that does it.
Khan, it's the book of Deuteronomy, Deuteronomy, chapter 18, verse 12. For all that do these things are an abomination unto Yahuwah. And because of these abominations, Yahuwah, that supreme power, doeth drive them out from before thee.
And so when we read verse 10, we learn that occultism, these activities, is ranked right alongside infanticide, burning of children, and sacrifices. So I'm going to read verse 10. Watch this.
Book of Deuteronomy, chapter 18, verse 10. There shall not be found among you anyone that maketh his son or his daughter to pass through the fire, or that useth divination, or an observer of times, or an enchanter, or a witch.
See that? See, the point is, the Most High views charmers, horoscopes, Ouija boards, fortune telling, magic, PSI, just as loathsome, and astrology. Now, the fourth thing that I like to point out, according to verse 12 again, is the Most High disposes and he destroys those that practice these things. That's what happened to Danielle Johnson. See, they eventually fall under his judgment as the nations that was actually driven out by Israel because of these abominations. The fifth thing I want to point out, we go back to verse 9. It follows that Yahuwah will command, you shall not learn and follow these abominations. So that's a commandment. Read verse 9 again. He's commanding you not to follow these abominations. That's very, very strong right there, man. Don't do them. But also don't even learn to do them. Okay.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 18, verse 9. When thou art come into the land which Yahuwah, thy supreme power, giveth thee, thou shalt not learn to do after the abominations of those nations.
See, where the deed is evil, every inclination to the deed is also evil. See that? So the Most High forbids people from any participation in occultism. We go back to verse 10. The sixth thing I could point out is that no one who practices these activities is allowed to stay amongst the Most High's people. That's why I had to cast that damn demon David A. out again, man. He keeps wanting to talk about this divination. And this is the same both in the Old Testament and the New Testament, man. So David's a good guy. Well, what do you call good? What are the standards that you're measuring good by? See, Moses is trying to impress on our mind the importance, the seriousness of the occultism by saying that those who practice these things cannot be found amongst Yahuwah's people. So it's clear then, man, that Deuteronomy 18, it is contrary to Yahuwah's will that his people engage in any of these activities, such as astrology, any kind of cult. That's a fact, bro. Anyone knows what the word Deuteronomy means? What does Deuteronomy mean? Hello. Silence. Silence of laughter when the truth is spoken. Oh, who's playing that music, man? It's gonna get me fried, man. They playing old school music, man.
That's my neighbors up.
Yeah, man, it's gonna get me flagged, man. That'd be a copyright right there. Nobody? What you gotta do is look up the meaning for it.
Looking right here, it says the words. Would these be the words?
It's a Greek word. It's not the Hebrew word. All right. So this is what you get when you deal with occults, man. And this is the Most High's perspective on it. This is what you get when you deal with the occultism. Let's get Deuteronomy 44:24-26. I think that's what I'm looking for. Let me see. Yeah, that's what I'm looking for. Now, actually, no, yeah, Shia. Isaiah 44:24.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 44 and verse 24. Thus saith Yahuwah, thy Redeemer, and he that formed thee from the womb. I am Yahuwah that make of all things, that stretcheth forth the heavens alone, that spreadeth abroad the earth by myself, that frustrateth the tokens of the liars, and maketh diviners mad, that turneth wise men backward, and maketh their knowledge foolish, that confirmeth the word of his servant and performeth the counsel of his messengers.
Okay, yeah, that's good on that. Nesif put the correct meaning of Deuteronomy. It means the second law. He's right. You see it in the room? That's what it means, the second law. Under King Manasseh, or you say Manasseh, Manasseh, right? Come on, man. Stop it. Take that back to Hillel Mitchell. So Judah was probably at the pinnacle of his evil under King Manasseh. Get 2 Kings 21:6. Because they stood at burning their sons in the fire, and they was practicing soothsaying and augury.
Look at 2 Kings 21:6. And he made his sons pass through the fire and observe times, and used enchantments, and dealt with familiar spirits and wizards. He wrought much wickedness in the sight of Adonai to provoke him to anger.
So he was involved in soothsaying and augury. Augury is like something coming like an omen. You're dealing with mediums, dealing with spirits of wizards, and so on and so forth. And so that's why I had Yirmiyahu, because Yeshaya was one of the prophets that the Most High sent to warn Judah also. But we learned that the Most High frustrated the omens in Yeshaya 47:12. Someone get Yeshaya 47:12. says the Most High frustrates the omens and he makes fools of the diviners.
Book of Yeshaya, Isaiah, chapter 47 and verse 12. Stand now with thine enchantments and with the multitude of thy sorceries, wherein thou hast labored from thy youth.
If so Isaiah 44 and 26. Isaiah 44 and 26.
Book of Isaiah, chapter 44 and verse 26. That confirmeth the word of his servant and performeth the counsel of his messengers.
So the Most High say, I'm going to carry out the word of my servant. Uh-huh. Okay.
That saith to Jerusalem, thou shalt be inhabited into the city.
Yeah, that means you're going to rise again. You're going to rise again. Okay.
Into the cities of Judah, ye shall be built. And I will raise up the decayed places thereof.
Come. See, understand this, man. When the word of the Most High, Yahuwah and Yahusha, captures a person's mind and heart, all involvement with magic, astrology goes out. See, it's Yahusha versus the occult. You can't have both. Can't have both. Galatians 5, verse 20. See, Galatians 5, 20 tells us that sorcery is the works of the flesh.
Go on, the book of Galatians, chapter 5, verse 20. Idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, immolations, wrath, strife, seditions, heresies.
So those are all works of the flesh, man. All works of the flesh. So it seems clear to me that the teachings of the scriptures of Yahuwah, people should not be involved in any practices of the occult. Practices which involves dealing with the world of spirits, supernatural forces. You're not supposed to be involved in that, man. Because what you're doing is belittling Yahuwah and exalting man. Most High is opposed to that, man. Most High is opposed to occult participation. Give me Genesis 3, verse 5. See, this is what Shaitan told Eve. If you go beyond what Yahuwah has appointed, then you shall become like God. That's how he got Eve. Most High say, don't do it. No, no, you can go ahead and do it. You become like God.
Come on. Book of Genesis, chapter 3, verse 5. For Yahuwah doth know that in the day ye eat thereof, then your eyes shall be opened, and ye shall be as gods.
See, the devil convinced a woman that she will become like God if she disobey him. That's what he did, man. And that's how you get a lot of you guys. All forms of occult present some sort of similar temptation. You're not acting like heavenly, you're not acting like heavenly children of the Heavenly Father, or humble children of the Heavenly Father, and submitting to the Most High's will. Are you going to belittle the Most High and listen to the devil? Choice is yours. a spiritual harlotry. See, any man or woman in the occult is a man or woman in harlotry. We read that in Leviticus 20 and 6. If a person turns to mediums and wizards and playing the harlot after them, you're a spiritual whore. Most High said, I'll set my face against that person. Consult to mediums. Go into astrology. See, that's like committing adultery against the Most High. HaMashiach is the husband of the church. He's the Most High's fullest revelation. All that we need to know and all the power, which is good for us, comes through him and his word. When we go after these secret oracles, these psychic powers, what we're really saying is that HaMashiach is unsatisfactory. And we must seek for lovers of ourselves. So when you peek into hot horoscope eaves, you're treating HaMashiach the same way a husband treats a wife when he peeks on the OnlyFans. When he starts looking at porn, he's committing spiritual murder. So he no longer gets, see what he's doing, he's looking for something he no longer could get from her. That's why he's watching the porn anyways. And any kind of woman that would deprive a man of sex, you're going to have to answer to the Most High for that, man. Because you're participating and pushing them towards fornication. See, involvement in the occult is wrong because it's spiritual adultery. It is rebellion against the sovereignty of Yahuwah. And it literally belittles his revelations while you exult in your human pride. So in my conclusion, what the heck do you as a believer have to do with an occult anyways? The answer is the same everywhere. New Testaments, Old Testaments. This is the victory that overcomes the world, our faith. A lot of people were still trying to fight, trying to justify being in the occult, following astrology, worshiping the planets. You better come up out of that thing, man. You better come up out of that thing, or the Most High is going to deal with you. We see the results of Danielle Johnson. They say it's a mystery. It's only a mystery to those that's not walking in the spirit, not walking in the Ruach HaKodesh. It's not a mystery to us. We know what happened. And save you, repent. Same thing may happen to you. Stay away from the occult world. It's demonic. It's of the devil. It's of Satan. I've said all I have to say, man. You all got something you want to speak on, you can. I dropped the link in the room about 10 minutes ago. Anyone that want to come on here, you got any questions? Bring them forth.
Prevalent spirit amongst the children of Israel, Lord.
Come.
Lots of evil are involved in divinations and tarot card readings, and they believe that, you know, there's even a good form of magic.
They call it white magic.
Right. Right. I've heard that before. They think that you could practice magic for good purposes. That's a big law.
They even treated things like good witches now, huh?
Make evil seem fairly. Make evil seem fairly.
Nah, the only good magic here is keeping the scriptures. That's the good magic.
Good faith.
Come. That's the real good magic.
You want wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, seek your Ua.
That's right.
It's folly. You putting that in front of the Most High. You're choosing that as your power.
There she go. Danielle Johnson.
We've learned that the suspect in this week's horrific murder-suicide was an online astrology influencer.
Look at her. Now, if you, I could look at her and see her spirit's not right. Look at her eyes. When you get the rule on you, man, certain spirits just don't mix with you, Well, if you look at her, some feelings should come over you to see that something's in her is not right, Look at her eyes. I hate to say it, I could see something demonic in her. Look at her eyes, man.
Here's a look at her, who posted about the solar eclipse being the apocalypse. Fox 11.
See what I'm saying? Cynthia was talking something like that. Who was on the, Yahusha being, you was on the call? She was trying to allude to the solar eclipse. Right? That's a man, when these Eve start talking like that, that's the devil. That's the devil, what? Then to justify it, she's trying to bring me down. Well, you know, he's just a man. Are you coming with demons? Made a waste hot. Most High cursed all of my enemies, man. Every single one of them. But you can see something about this woman's not right, huh?
Gina Silva, she's live with developing new information on this case tonight. Gina?
Marla, this case has been so shocking from beginning to end, and now we're...
Look, they don't... You know why they don't understand it, Because they're... Someone give me 1 Corinthians, man, 3 and 17. See, he that is spiritual judgeth all things. These people don't understand what's going on, These people are of the world, man. They look at us as crazy and look at her as normal. You see, whole scope like it's nothing. Guy, you got that up?
Kahan, the book of 1 Corinthians, 3, verse 17. If any man defile the temple of Yahuwah, and him shall Yahuwah destroy. For the temple of Yahuwah is holy, which temple ye are.
See that? And this is what you're doing, man. You define when you allow something to attach you into you, you're destroying the temple, man. From there, go to 1 Corinthians 2:15. See, these people don't get it, but we get it. Because they're not spiritual.
Come. The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 2, verse 15. But he that is spiritual judgeth all things. Yet he himself is judged of no man.
You see what I'm saying? Living in a luxury apartment. And this is what happens with a lot of these YouTubers out. They're out here making money off of debtors. Off of people that's lost their souls. Well, like this woman. This woman is making money, making profits, off of divination and living quite wealthy. They let it go. You talk the word of the Most High. They don't want to hear this, They don't want to hear this fire-headed we doing right now.
we're learning about a new disturbing layer to this tragedy.
A lot of our foundations as a society are toxic. They're ungrounded and they're unrealistic.
LAPD confirms Danielle Johnson.
Look at her eyes, man. Tell me this chick look normal to you guys, man.
She look bad. Crazy.
Yeah, man. I can read spirits out.
Johnson, a.k.a. Danielle Ayoka, seen here on the Scotty and Sylvia.
Look at these. Look at these. Look at her followers out.
The show was an astrology influencer on social media who was concerned about the eclipse.
Eclipses, there's...
Let's go back to them. Let's see who they are.
About the
they
eclipse.
Better get out of there.
Eclipses, there's more births, there's more deaths.
Look at that. And she ended up dying.
The eclipse.
Eclipses, there's more births, there's more death.
Who was concerned about the eclipse?
Eclipses, there's more births, there's more death.
Answer on social media. Who was concerned about the eclipse?
Flashing a watch. Look at her watch, huh? She's flashing a watch. She's forcing it.
On the Scotty and Sylvia show.
Let me see who this is. They don't have no names up there.
That's the name of their show up at the top.
Wow. Now what? Society are toxic. They are ungrounded and they are unrealistic.
Yeah, yeah. So was that car.
Was an astrology influence.
A yoka.
On social media, who was concerned about the eclipse.
Eclipses, there's more births, there's more deaths.
Leading up to the eclipse on Monday, Danielle, who...
I couldn't tell the difference. What was the eclipse, the car or the moon or the sun?
I'm not sure what you mean, huh?
Nah, I'm saying that I can't tell the difference. Was the sun the eclipse or was it her car? Because her car looked like the eclipse to me when she hit that tree.
Okay, so she is also known as Danielle Ayoka. You get more information when you put that name in, too.
You can go and see the tweets, huh?
And by the handle Mystic X Lipstick, made several alarming.
See, there's another false prophet. What did the Most High tell you about false prophets? That's another false prophet saying the apocalypse is here. Same kind of thing Cynthia was talking, huh? She went and watched some video. Yeah, keep going. Everyone who has ears, listen. The Most High showed her. Huh? Look at the power of Satan trying to reach on people. Your time to choose what you believe in is now. If you believe in a new world, it's possible for the people right now. There's power in choice. There's power in choice. But she that's propaganda right there. Now, all of these followers under this vibration. Mystic X Lipstick.
Posts like these. Wake up, wake up. The apocalypse is here. And the eclipse is the...
She put all of this here out and go and stab that man. This has to be hosted by Shaitan. Wow.
Epitome of spiritual warfare. She also reposted alerts that signaled, this is the final warning. Something big is coming.
This type of story is...
And go Esau with his two cents. And Esau are going to philosophize on it. Huh? There go Esau. He's so-called, I bet he's an astrologist, analyst, expert. You know what I'm saying? There go Esau now. Stop it, man.
It's probably one of the most tragic and horrifying stories that we'll ever hear about.
How many times have we heard that before? How many times have we heard most tragic and terrifying we'll ever hear?
Every time. Many times. Every time.
The rest of us, clinical psychologist Dr. David Swanson, who never treated Danielle, is trying to make sense of this horrific tragedy. Just hours before the eclipse was to take place over California, Danielle stabbed her boyfriend to death in Woodland Hills, pushed her kids out of a moving car on the 405 freeway in the Westchester area, which resulted in the death of her 8-month-old baby and the injury of her 9-year-old daughter. Then
look at that car. Look at that car, huh?
Yeah, that's the eclipse. That that's the eclipse.
Look at that car, man.
Damn.
The tree passed over it, man.
She's giving people spiritual advice. This is your astrology? What is this lady saying right here? You BL, you can come on the call. You got a question. BL, you can come on the call if you got a question. Because we don't understand your shorthand. Oh, here's another one. It's Martez. You could come on the call if you got a question. Don't be a keyboard gangster. Come on the call. You got a question. We'll address it directly. Now, you could tell who's wearing that spirit. I could tell just by the comments. You see what I'm saying? But I want them to come on the call. We'll address this now, here and now.
Danielle died after crashing her Porsche into a tree in Redondo Beach.
Perhaps she thought that this eclipse meant that it was the end of the world. The apocalypse was here, especially because of some of this.
He goes off. Well, I mean, she definitely thought that, what? That's what she put on her text.
Statements that she made.
There were plenty of
look at these people following it, man.
Similar post.
Look at these people following it. All these astrologers, Anna and Tim. Astrologers, huh?
So.
And Marie, how you been, huh? Call it that. I call it judgment, huh? I call it judgment. It's the judgment of the Most High, huh? It's two forces, man. It's Yahuwah and Satan. That's what she said, right? She's going to have to choose. I guess she chose, right? I guess she chose.
And videos on social media predicting all kinds of disasters and the end of the world.
This is the kind of stuff, and this is what I told you guys about Cynthia. This is the same garbage she was trying to push on Alicia and brought it to me, and this is why I cut her. This is why I cut her, huh? Because you got to watch out. Just put, she had a spirit on her, huh?
Yeah.
When she trying to, you know, rebuke for trying to put the high holy day on a day while everyone, you coming with demons, man. Then you're going to cite something about, she cited something about And it's always Eve citing something about the eclipse. You can go over there and stay with them, whoever you was with, man. On anything I love, man. Because we don't need that vibration over here, man. Go back to church. Put your church clothes on. Because we don't do that over here. We don't do that over here. But she putting love, love. See this right here? This is brainwashing. Repeating the same thing. This is going into your subconscious.
Yes, that's very deceptive.
What's that?
The whole using many of the same words over and over and over again, trying to convince, you know, folks of things. And the fact that this took place, it highlights Cynthia's stance. You know what I'm saying? It highlights her stance.
Okay.
And Jeannie's she has something coming to her. From her, because I mean, we already read, you brought up that none of that stuff has any hold on Jacob or Israel. So not on Jacob or any of his seed, you know, for those of us that are true believers. I mean, it's also written in the Bible, the sun, the moon, the star, it's only there for us to be able to keep track of time. You use it outside of anything else besides that, start worshiping it, you're trying to take control of folks' minds, manipulate people's lives, you in a whole nother realm. And she's relying on that as a stance to guide her dang on emotions to try to come against the body. And you gotta go.
Come on. BL, we don't understand what you're saying. BL, you could click the link and come in the room. Welcome your question. What's up?
I think she's saying, are you Black Hebrew Israelites?
I'm not sure what that is.
BL, that's the truth. What is that?
Yeah, I don't know what that is.
BL, can you enlighten me on that? I'm not sure what you're talking about. What is a Black Hebrew Israelite? If that's what you mean. I'm not sure what you mean by that. What is that? Is that some sort of new street gang? You have to help me out with that one. I'm just me. Every man on here is just him. Who are you?
On TikTok or you're on social media, and clearly she was an influencer, so you know she watched a lot of this stuff. It's very easy to get sucked into the fear that these videos start to create.
Could this have been postpartum depression?
I don't think it would have been totally postpartum depression.
You see, I eat. Look. Man, what is, come on, man.
That's
the thing to keep Eve out of the forefront.
So postpartum depression makes you kill the father of your child.
She's looking for somewhere to justify Eve's actions. You know why? Because she probably believes in horoscopes and astrology and don't want that. They don't want the dirt on it. Let's call it what it was, man. It was demonic.
Depression, because we have a lot of women who deal with postpartum depression and it doesn't result in something like that.
There you go.
Exactly.
There you go. There you go. But you see how Eve trying to save Eve? How can Satan cast out Satan, man?
But certainly any type of mood disorder makes it much harder to cope with other things as they start to come up.
Looking at this tragedy.
Look at that,
man.
Look at that. You saw that, Ephraim? See that car? Look at that.
Damn, man.
What's on you, man, to do that? You're going 100 up. The thing becomes like a missile. When you start going a certain speed, the car starts hydroplaning.
Oh yeah, get air.
Yeah.
She was driving a Porsche.
Yep.
Dr. Swanson says there were obvious signs. The happy and smiling Danielle had changed and was struggling with something dark.
See that? With something dark. with something dark. They don't want to say it, man. This is demonic, man. Well, man, get a spiritual man on here and tell them what's going on. The doctors, they're always going to try and relate it to something scientific.
Facts.
She was warning people. She was saying, pick a side. The way that she typed about it was in all caps. It looked like she was very disturbed.
If the hindsight's always 2020, huh?
She was hindsight very possessed.
2020. What was that on?
No, she was very possessed by demons.
They do that all the time, no, trying to fix a spiritual issue with a man-made science.
Yeah.
It's, at least Esau said some of the truth in that, the little statement he said.
Yeah. Yeah, they got to tell you, but then again, they want to leave you in the dark still about it. They're never like straightforward, like, you know what I'm saying? That's why they say, oh, in the dark, struggling with something, you know, like, but what, you know? But they telling you if you can read between the lines.
The lady said, it's a sign of postpartum depression. Are you serious, man?
I've heard it all. I heard it all.
It's a joke. Wow.
Wow.
And they found tarot cards and black feathers.
Mm-hmm.
What could you be doing while you're driving? Like, was she like, come on, man. Well, did she really think like following tarot cards was gonna help her out? I mean, come on, man. That's not, it's the end of the world, but you end your life and everybody, the next day everybody's looking at, you know, the news now. It's ridiculous, man.
Hey, Shabbat Shalom to everybody. Just want to say that real quick.
Shalom, Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, man. What's up?
Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom, up.
Shabbat Shalom.
Come.
You know, that name, Yoka. Is an African name that's supposed to mean one who causes joy. I don't know if that suffices to say.
No, not at all. Or maybe just joy in the beginning, but everything's like that. Hopefully he will take a look at these long-term consequences, because this is not an isolated incident.
Okay, so she described herself on her Twitter bio as a music artist also. She described herself as a music artist, a healer. She was into that that healing, you know, what do they call it? Reiki, that Japanese pseudoscience that they use alternative to medicine. Y'all know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Talking about
I know what you're talking about. Where they use like the suction cups during injury or stuff like that. I know what you're talking about.
Acupuncture?
No, that's something else. That's different.
A rake is when you're using your hands, like your physical hands.
Yeah, well, she say she was a Reiki healer, a recording artist. Well, actually, she went on to say she was a recording artist, an astrologer, and a Reiki master teacher. And they say she'd been posting under that handler of Mystic Lipstick since 2015. The way that she built the following was posting zodiacs and the chart readings and astrological advice. And then she started offering these people self-help healing sessions and energy cleansings for free. Imagine having your energy cleansed by someone like that.
Nah, nope, I'm good.
So they said in 2016, she started describing herself as a skill healer. And so they say she was known for her insanely true astrological insight. And it says someone named Refinery 29, it published her Star Guided Tips for Career Success. And it says, as of this week right here, she had nearly over 104,000 Twitter followers. So that shows you how docile people really are, man. And they say leading up, now, isn't it odd how someone that's into all of this astrology stuff starts talking about the apocalypse? They always got to resort to the Bible. You guys notice that?
Come on.
Every time.
They say leading up to this, her death, she started, her post was filled with apocalypse posts warning about the eclipse.
She must have been predicting her own death, man. Because it's all right. If the eclipse is coming, okay, then what? You want, like, what was the point of what you did, though?
I was just thinking that, like, she brought up her own apocalypse upon herself.
Yeah. The eclipse was her car, man. It was like a motor eclipse, man. The tree going through the car, not the sun. Crazy.
They say, she started some conspiracy thing about the COVID. And then on April the 4th, she wrote that the impending eclipse would be the epitome of spiritual warfare. And then she urged her followers to pick a side. And they say the next day she told them that the apocalypse was here. Yeah, the only one that witnessed her stabbing her boyfriend was a 9-year-old daughter. It's a mystery, man. Wow.
Wow. She had to be possessed, man.
It's nothing other than demonic, man. Mella King, what you think about this? Shalom. Shabbat shalom. No comment, huh?
Yo, shalom. I thought my mic was on. Shalom, family. Oh, man. Yo, I know you go hard on us as brothers, as men. But I'm gonna bring some compassion towards the situation. Now, with Danielle Johnson has said, like brothers here, we don't want no woman like that. We want virtuous women. We need virtuous women. It's unfortunate, sad how Danielle stabbed her ish and her children now. Well, I think she had two daughters or something. The 9-year-old daughter gonna be traumatized. Then we got a 9-year-old daughter. She don't have any parents. So now she probably not, if she dealing with the state or whatnot, the Europeans gonna try to hit her off with foster care. That's if her granddad or if her grandmother don't step up, or her uncles or aunts don't come through and take over as parents. So that's damn near worse than quote unquote black on black crime down there. A brother shoot a brother, he dead, and a brother go to jail. That's a loss. But as far as like the sisters, like we don't want that around here. We need women that's gonna be strong. We need women that's going to attend a man's business when he need help. You hear? They here to be a help me. We don't want no woman that's gonna be argumentative. We don't need no woman that's going to bring different spirits to the house. So we don't need that. We go against the system. We go against this beast every day. Now, for that woman Danielle Johnson, she's showing an example of why women shouldn't listen to influencers over the YouTube and internet, because you never know what they will attend to. To all my sisters out there, this should be definitely a warning, an eye opener for you to comprehend that we living through some times whereas anything goes, and it's the spirit out here with I'm about to get explicit. Homosexuality, transgenderism. We don't even know that's a man or a woman.
Can't say it on YouTube, huh? Can't say it on YouTube. Shalom. Have a nice day. No, he know that. Anyone else? This is not the forum for that. I'm going to do that. Do it on Rumble when we're not on YouTube. Anyone else? What about MRA, Yaya Bay? Any of you good brothers got anything up?
I was just going to say, it just seems like a lot of these things is just like distractions. You know, we a lot of people are getting caught up in these things and distraction from, you know, to keep them in the state that they're in, from not getting help in whatever field it is, like health or, you know, whatever, their own health, their own mental health, their own financial health, whatever it is. It's like, it's all like, it seems like it's a distraction. But I also, something popped up in my head when you said she was like saying she was a musician, but because I keep hearing this over the years, like, you know how they say that Satan was like a musician or something like that? And I'm kind of doing a little bit of research, like trying to find out the verse that it says that. But I don't know what would be the opinion on that, because, you know, obviously music is a distraction. with the way they put it on us, the way it's portrayed out there in the mainstream and stuff like that. But I just kind of wanted to see like the opinion on that.
Is it, there's no indication that she was listening to any kind of music that provoked this. The one thing is clear is she was in astrology, which the Most High is against. And this is what did it, her astrology and the tarot cards. When you get involved in stuff like that, it opens you up to the spiritual world. But as we brought out today, you're not dealing with the spirit of the Most High. And there's a lot of people that like to deal with those kind of spirits. And like her, they're not going to accept that is wrong because they're under Satan's authority. She thought that she was right. But she was actually in a very dark place. And so with that many followers, what is that telling you? Every single person that was listening to her and couldn't discern, hey, this is not right, they're in a dark place also. They're in a very dark place also. And I can almost guarantee you probably got some people on her channel trying to justify what happened. I was on her page right now when astrologers trying to say, I just want everyone to understand, not all astrologers are like that.
Wow.
Yeah. I'm going to drop this link on her page, huh? I'm going to drop this video link on her page. Where it at?
Come on. I didn't know you could go live on Twitter. I said it.
Yeah, you have to have a premium account. I haven't been going live over there, so there's not very many people watching. Yeah, this right here is nothing opinionated. It's factual. This is of the devil, man. That there's nothing. You know why they don't understand it? Because they're looking. They want to look for some scientific reason. How do we justify this? How do we show this in science? It's of the devil, man. That's of the devil, man. That's why they can't, you know, they can't figure it out. It's of the devil. Anyone that's following that, man, they need to come up out of it. That's not of the Most High, man. Oh, she put on her page, we could do it, in all caps, we could do it. Believe me, you magic is in what you believe. I believe we can be free. All caps, believe we can be free. And you got many people that was, you know, responding to that. She got 250 likes to that. So look at those minds on that, man. 9,000 people viewed that.
And whoever liked after. We can do it.
Oh, your mic's not working, huh?
I'm saying whoever liked it, they encouraged her. That gave a back in her back. We can do it.
Come on. Well, you got 250 people that liked it and 9,000 some that watched it. Yeah. All right, seems like you guys are done. It's heavy, y'all. You got to guard your spirit out here, man. Everybody want to follow something, man. You know what I mean? Everybody want to follow something.
Now, you know what I think it is, too? I think, like, you know, the Most High, he not going to give you what you want. But the Most High, he going to give you what you need, and he going to give you that love and protection. But with them, see, they want to get what they want. And through these spirits and demons, you know, they get the satisfaction from it. You know what I'm saying? Whether they sell their soul for whatever, or materialistic, or, you know, things that they want to inherit. But essentially, like, once you give that up, man, nothing that these demons or the devil give you could amount what you just lost from the Most High. Like, I mean, because you could laugh now, but then you're going to cry later. But if you, bro, the Most High going to give you everything you need, and you work it out. That's the best gift, because whatever, you cry now, whatever, you're going through it. But that fire, that pressure going to turn you to a diamond. And you'll be winning at the end. So, you know, it's not very wise to choose that side, that dark side, because at the end, it's like you're not going to be where you want, no matter what you get or what you possess. And when you with the Most High, none of that black magic, dark magic, none of that could touch you, man. When you really walk in the, when you how when you really trying to, like, you being sincere about it, no matter what they do, their works and weapons, you know, won't come against you. So I'd rather have that, you know, just deal with that.
Cool. Right, witchcraft only work on people not rooted in the word. Seems faring to the ears, but in those ways thereof are death. And that was a gruesome death. You're going so fast, the car almost split in half through a tree. You know, there's a lot of people don't believe in a spiritual world. And like Kahan just said, they're trying to use, you know, man-made science and hypothesize and try to theorize as to why this happened, this and the third. They really don't believe that, you know, HaShaitan is moving to and fro through the earth, seeing who he can inhabitate. And when you invoke tarot cards and all that nonsense, which none of that stuff is new, because if that was beneficial back then, why, you know, all those people were considered witches. That was a bad thing. But now, you know, they're trying to promote that as some type of healing method or guidance. You know, we're really in the days of, it's like, this is getting worse and worse. These things are being fully accepted by society at a larger scale. So, all I can say is put your trust and faith in Yahuwah. Don't be swayed by the ways of man and these offerings, you know, from Satan. Because it's really, that's really what it is. She made a contract with HaShaitan, and I guess it was time to pay. I don't know.
Okay.
But that was a very gruesome death. And that really should set a...
The boyfriend's also.
And he had to... a side note to that. He had to know, you know, to a certain extent, what he was getting himself into. Because for E to be that deep into that, to have thousands and hundreds of thousands of followers and talking about this and the third, you don't see that? You're just going to ignore all that. I don't, you know. Wow.
it's a horror movie. So it's what this people be liking, man. And I'll be like, man, all these if you put like a random like so-called movie, a lot of it starts with like some type of weird scenario like this or something. Like it's a lot of you know, I wouldn't be surprised if this would be like a some type of Hollywood movie in a few years.
Yeah, they like making stuff about, you know, the occult and stuff like that.
You know, OJ Orange Juice Jones Simpson died, right? Now they want that 33.5 million that, you know, for the wrongful death of those two people. Yeah, he died a few days ago. Orange Juice Jones.
Yeah, yeah. Come.
You didn't even hardly hear much about it, huh?
Nah.
He said, does the glove fit?
Yeah, that's the part right there. Up with him holding up that glove, boy. Johnny Cochran. That's the part right there. That glove. It's a famous photo. Right there. Towards. Yeah. See that? See that right there, them gloves?
Yep. Yeah.
That part right there.
Does it fit?
That's the only time OJ smiled during the entire trial. Otherwise, he had a poker face. When the glove didn't fit, he knew he had something.
Yeah, man.
Boy, it's a cold world out here, boy. It's a fact, huh? It's a cold, cold world. He's over there where Maury is, man. Or he was in Nevada.
Yeah, it's the number one state of mental health. I just found that out. That's crazy. But I could tell. Yeah, I could tell too. I mean, just by walking.
Yeah. They're gambling, though. They'd be driving people crazy. Lose everything gambling, huh?
Yep.
Some people go there with their entire check. You don't even know a person has a gambling problem, huh? They look normal until they get some money in their hands. Then they turn into a Jason Wesley. But I think it's time to bring this to an end, man. We thank everyone for tuning in. Should have gotten a lot more donations. And one more time, I'm going to welcome you to come out to the seminar. If you guys haven't paid for the seminar, need to get an Airbnb and all of that. You need to get that stuff in now. Because we're coming up on this quick. Today's the 13th. It's coming up quick, man. This is the link right ahead to register for the seminar now. And Passover. Definitely, if you haven't paid for the Passover, man, you need to get that in.
Amari, you going to be able to make it to the Passover, B?
Boys in Vegas.
No, not this time, but you guys have a great one. You going over there, right?
Yeah. Yep.
Yeah. 27.
It's right around the corner now, man. Announced this a minute ago.